As with liquid pesticides, equipment for applying granular formulations must be calibrated. Calibrate granular applicators each time you use a new product. Granules vary in size and shape from one pesticide to the next, and this affects the flow rate. You should also recalibrate the equipment each time the weather changes, since temperature and humidity affect the flow of granules. Before you begin, make sure that the equipment is clean and working properly. When you calibrate a granule applicator, you must use the actual pesticide. Be sure to wear the label and regulation prescribed personal protective equipment, including eye protection, gloves, long sleeves, and shoes and socks. Carry out your calibration process at the treatment site or a similar site labeled for the pesticide, and measure out a test area for the calibration process. Read the pesticide label to determine the pesticide application rate. Rates will be given as amount of product per area. The pesticide should have a booklet with information on different spreader settings for the desired rate of application. If your spreader is listed, set it to the appropriate setting as a starting point. Calibration of a granule applicator requires measuring three things: the travel speed, swath width, and output rate. Let's start with the travel speed. For drop spreaders and rotary spreaders hand-pushed or held at the chest, walk at a consistent pace the entire time you operate the equipment. 3 miles per hour is standard walking speed when pushing a spreader. Determine the travel speed for equipment placed on the back of a tractor in feet per minute. Fill up the applicator's hopper with the pesticide granules so that you can measure the speed under actual operating weight. Use a 100-foot tape to measure off a convenient distance, such as 200 or 300 feet. Mark the beginning and end with a marker, such as red flagging tape. Have someone drive the equipment through the measured distance while maintaining the desired speed. Note, do not apply the granules at this step. Begin driving before crossing the start marker so you can be sure you've reached your desired speed by the time you start your measurements. Use a stopwatch to determine how many minutes and seconds it takes to travel the measured distance. Repeat this process 2 to 3 more times and calculate the average speed. Figure your travel speed by dividing your distance traveled by your average time. Here is an example. Say your trips were 1 minute 30 seconds, 1 minute 25 seconds, and 1 minute 45 seconds. First, you would have to convert these all to minutes. So for your first trip, 30 seconds multiplied by 1 minute per 60 seconds equals 0.5 minutes. 1 minute 30 seconds equals 1.5 minutes. The next equals 1.42 minutes. And finally, the last equals 1.75 minutes. Adding the 3 up and dividing by 3 gives you an average of 1.56 minutes for your travel time. The measured distance traveled was 300 feet. Divide that by the time it took you, 300 divided by 1.56 minutes, and you get 192.3 feet per minute for your travel speed. To find the swath width, operate the equipment under actual field conditions. You can use a strip of plastic such as a tarp that contrasts with the color of the granules. This gives you a rapid visual assessment of granule distribution and swath width. If possible, you can place trays or other containers at even intervals across the application swath to collect the granules. Weigh the granules in the trays separately to get an idea of the distribution pattern. To determine the output rate, fill the hopper with the granular pesticide. Most granular hoppers have adjustable openings for the granules to pass through. Refer to the manufacturer's instructions to determine the appropriate opening for the desired rate, and, if using a tractor, the speed of the tractor. The easiest way to calibrate a granule spreader is to collect and weigh the granules applied to a known area. Spread out a plastic tarp of known size on the ground. Operate the spreader at a known speed across the tarp. Collect the granules from the tarp into a container and weigh them. Say, for example, that the tarp size was 10 feet by 12 feet. The area of the tarp is 10 times 12. Or 120 square feet. If the swath width is larger than the tarp width, use the area of the tarp in the calculations. However, if the swath width is less than the width of the tarp, then calculate the area by measuring the actual swath width, and multiplying it by the length of the tarp. Now say that you collected 8 ounces of granules. Convert that to pounds with a conversion factor of 16 ounces per pound. Multiply 8 ounces by 1 over 16 ounce per pound to get a half a pound of collected granules. Then, divide the weight of the granules collected by the area, and that is the output rate. So, if we had 0.5 pounds applied over 120 square feet, then the resulting output rate is 0.004 pounds per square foot. For smaller spreaders, such as hand-operated equipment or hand-push spreaders, fill the hopper with a known weight of granules and operate the equipment over a known area. After a known amount of time, weigh the granules remaining in the spreader. The difference in the weight is the amount of granules applied to the area. If your calculations do not match the labeled rate, then you need to adjust the equipment and recalibrate. Motorized and hand-operated applicators apply granules at a fixed output rate, independent of ground speed. If the label calls for a greater amount, you need to open the port more or slow the speed of travel. If the label rate is less than your output, close the port slightly or increase the speed. Once you make an adjustment, repeat the calibration procedure until the correct output rate is reached. Let's try an example. Say you are using a broadcast spreader with a swath width of 10 feet and going 200 feet per minute. Your output rate is 2.5 pounds per minute, and the total area you are applying granules to is 1,200 square feet. To find out how many pounds of granules you will apply to get proper coverage of 1,200 square feet, first determine the area treated per minute by multiplying the swath width by the travel speed. 10 feet multiplied by 200 feet per minute gives you 2,000 square feet per minute. Then, to determine the pounds of pesticide being applied per square foot, divide the output rate by the area covered. So, 2.5 pounds per minute divided by 2,000 square feet per minute equals 0.00125 pounds per square feet. Finally, find out how many pounds are needed for 1,200 square feet. Multiply 1,200 by 0.00125 pounds per square feet to get 1.5 pounds.